everyone. In our last class, we learned about conversion of units of volume. In that, we learned to convert greater units of volume into smaller units and to convert smaller units of volume into greater units. So, dear students, in this class, let us solve exercise problems on that topic. Exercise 6.2. Convert the following. In that, first question, -liter. You know that 1 liter = 1000 milliliter. Therefore, 5 liter = cross multiply here. 5 into 1000 by 1, we get 5 into 1000, we get 5000. So 5 liter = 5000 milliliter. Next, second question is 6 kiloliter = -liter. Second question, 6 kiloliter = -liter. You know that 1 kiloliter = 1000 liter. Therefore, 6 kiloliter = cross multiply here, 6 into 1000 by 1. 6 into 1000, we get 6000 liter. Therefore, 6 kiloliter = 6000 liter. Now consider third example, 500 milliliter = -liter. You know that 1000 milliliter = 1 liter. Therefore, 500 milliliter = cross multiply here, we get. In our last class, we learnt about conversion of units of volume. In that, we learnt to convert greater units of volume into smaller units and to convert smaller units of volume into greater units. So, dear students, in this class, let us solve exercise problems on that topic. Exercise 6.2. Convert the following. In that, first question, 5 liter = -milliliter. You know that 1 liter = 1000 milliliter. Therefore, 5 liter = cross multiply here, 5 into 1000 by 1, we get 5 into 1000, we get 5000. So 5 liter = 5000 milliliter. Next, second question is 6 kiloliter = -liter. Second question, 6 kiloliter equal to dash liter. You know that 1 kiloliter equal to 1000 liter. Therefore, 6 kiloliter equal to, cross multiply here, 6 into 1000 by 1. 6 into 1000, we get 6000 liter. Therefore, 6 kiloliter equal to 6000 liter. Now consider third example, 500 milliliter equal to dash liter. You know that 1000 milliliter equal to 1 liter. You know that 1000 milliliter equal to 1 liter.
Minus 1.
less than 100, so put 5 at 0. Now it become 550. 100 5s are 500. Now subtract 0 minus 0, 0, 5 minus 0, 5, 5 minus 5, 0, and take 0 here. 100 5s are 500. Now subtract, we get the remainder 0. So 1500 550 milliliter equal to 1 liter. 550 milliliter. Add this 1 liter to 41 liter. We get 41 plus 1, 42 liter. We get 42 liter 550 milliliter. Next, we move on to third problem. 8 kiloliters, 250 liters, 3 kiloliters, 350 liters, 4 kiloliters, 550 liters. Add, we get 0 plus 0, 0, 0 plus 0, 0. 5 plus 5, 10. 10 plus 5, 15. Carry 1. 2 plus 1, 3. 3 plus 3, 6. 6 plus 5, 11. 8 plus 3, 11. 11 plus 4, 15. 15 kiloliters, 1150 liters. You know that 1000 liter equal to 1 kiloliter.
Next, second example.
Second, subtract 45 liter 800 milliliter from 75 liter 750 milliliter. 45 liter 750 milliliter 45 liter 800 milliliter. Now subtract, we get 0 minus 0 0, 5 minus 0 5. Is this possible to subtract? No. Take borrow from here. Now it becomes 17 17 minus 8 9. Here remaining is 4. Is this possible to subtract? No. No. Take borrow from here. Now it becomes 14. 14 minus 5, 9. Here remaining is 6. 6 minus 4, we get 2. 29 liter, 950 milliliter. Next, fourth question. solve the following. In the first question, Veena buys 3 liter 250 milliliter of groundnut oil. While returning from her office, her mother also bought 1 liter 500 milliliter of groundnut oil on the same day. What is the total quantity of groundnut oil bought by them? First, Veena buys the 3 liter 250 milliliter. Her mother bought the oil 1 liter 500 milliliter. Therefore, now find out the total quantity of groundnut oil bought by them get 0 plus 0 0, 5 plus 0 5, 2 plus 5 7, 3 plus 1 4. Therefore, total quantity of groundnut oil bought by them is 4 liter. Second question, a milkman has 25 liters of milk. He sells 16 liter 750 milliliter of it. Find the quantity of milk left with him. Second question. A milkman has the milk 25 liter. He sells the milk 16 liter 750 milliliter. Now find the quantity of milk left with him. Therefore, quantity of milk left with him is, now subtract here 0 minus 0 0. Is this possible to subtract? No, no. Take borrow from 5. Here, now it becomes 10. Now take borrow from here. Now it becomes 10. 10 minus 5? 5. Here remaining is 9. 9 minus 7? 2. Here remaining is 4. Is this possible to subtract? No. Take borrow from here. Now it becomes 14. 14 minus 6? 8. Here remaining 1. 1 minus 1? 0. Therefore, total quantity of milk left with him is 8 liter 250 milli. Next, we move on to third problem. A bottle contains 1 liter 500 milliliter of sandal oil. It has to be filled into bottles of 250 milliliter each. How many bottles are required? 1 liter, 500 milliliter. It has to be filled into bottles of 250 milliliter each. It is filled in a bottle of 250 milliliter each. Now find out how many bottles are required to fill 1 liter 500 milliliter. You know that 1 liter equal to 1000 milliliter. Now convert 1 liter to milliliter. We get 1000 milliliter equal to 1 liter. Therefore, milliliter, we get 1500 milliliter. So a bottle contains the sandal oil 1500 milliliter. So 6 bottles required. Therefore 6 bottles required to fill the sandal oil. So dear students, in this class we learned about how to solve the problems on volume.